people might be aware of what it means to be healthy, but it's not only about knowledge. There are also social determinants of health, like the culture. What is cheap and affordable? Where can they practice healthy practices? Are there facilities? Is it open for everyone? Beirut is the city that has everything from everywhere. You can see the world in one city, and it has become bigger. 50% of the Lebanese residents come to Beirut and live in Beirut. So it has been growing vertically and horizontally as well. In addition, we also have the Syrian refugees, which are around 1.2 million. And you know, Lebanon now has the highest ratio of refugees in the world. The infrastructure of our healthcare system has been already weak before the refugee crisis. And with the increased number of people who need health assistance and healthcare, the system has been overstretched beyond the capacity. In addition, the cost of healthcare, of course, has increased for organizations, for the private sector, for the government, and for the self-payers. The health problems that are faced by the people here is related to chronic illnesses like diabetes and hypertension and cardiac disease. Beirut has one of the highest rates of diabetes in the whole world. The area of Naba, where we are right now, is one of the suburbs of Beirut. And it's home for a variety of people who were displaced mainly, fleeing war activities. It's considered one of the poorest areas in Beirut. And there are other places also around Beirut that are very similar. People have the same kind of challenges. They have the same social problems of unemployment, low salaries, risky environments, and the services available by the government are very limited. And people have to seek services either from political parties who provide services in the area or non-governmental organizations who have clinics in the area. Some of the people living here do not have families. Their families are the people of the NGOs. A lot of the problems are related not only to biological or genetic predisposition, it's also related to behavior and eating habits, so lifestyle, and also related to the environment and the services that the city can provide. You can see that a lot of electric wiring is around. Water and sewage water are in the streets, and there are no spaces for children to play, so I'm expecting children would play in the streets and not where they have space. The inability to do practice and limitation for their mobility might also lead to chronic illnesses later on in their lives, like diabetes. People, because they are poor, they might be facing some diseases that they don't know of because they are not screened regularly. And the consequences and complications of diseases will become worse because of their limited ability to deal with it. It is very important to take the social determinants into consideration when you want to do a health intervention. If a person is biologically fit and doesn't have any medical illness, but they are unemployed or they are poor, or their legal status is not proper, or they do not have access to the health services available, they are at risk of developing many illnesses. When they do develop these illnesses, the risk of having consequences of these illnesses are very high because they cannot afford it, so they will not take care of their illness, or will be diagnosed very late, or will not have access to medicine, and that's how their situation will deteriorate. Despite the gloomy outlook and the very dark image that we see of Lebanon and of Beirut, I see hope in the people, in the neighborhoods, in the people that work in organizations. Beirut can be a healthier city, and people, when they have the capacity and when they are given the opportunity, they would follow a healthy lifestyle. They would be able to seek assistance when they need it. But first of all, we need to have a clear healthcare system that is accessible to everyone, not only to people who can afford it. Health is a right. We cannot limit it to people who are able to buy this right.